Now, talk about a run. Sunrun stock ran up some 400% in 2020 and is continuing its upward trajectory. With me now to discuss the driving forces behind the solar industry's growth and what's ahead for Sunrun in 2021 is the company's CFO, Tom vonReichbauer. Thanks for being here today, Tom.
Thanks for having me. Great to be here.
All right. So Sunrun stock had a huge year in 2020. To what do you attribute the company's success over the last year? I mean, it was a year that was truly unprecedented in so many ways.
Yeah, you know, we really did have a great year. The Sunrun team, who's been on this journey for, you know, more than 13 years now, really did an excellent job of, you know, pivoting our business and powering through a challenging year on many fronts. We successfully transitioned to a virtual selling model early in the year. We're able to, you know, get through the early challenges in the spring with the onset of COVID and just transition the way we operate. So selling to customers in a virtual environment, making sure we had continuity of our ability to install. I think the real thing here was, you know, we had the right product for the right moment in time. Consumers were spending more time at home, spending more on residential electricity, thinking more about their home environment. And against that backdrop, we saw increasing utility prices, we saw increasing grid reliability issues, and we could offer customers a product where they could get into something that was more affordable, more reliable, and cleaner for society overall. Really was the right product at the right moment in time. And so a lot of exciting things setting us up for a really strong 2021.
Yeah, it sounds like a really big opportunity for you guys. And speaking of opportunities, the company acquired Vivint Solar last year. Can you talk a little bit about why that acquisition made sense for the company?
Yeah, the acquisition of the Vivint team is a really exciting moment for us to take a sort of step function change in the scale of our operations. So with that team coming on board, we crossed the 500,000 customer threshold, much larger footprint for us, added a really incremental route to market for us. So Vivint historically had sold through their direct-to-home channel, selling to customers, you know, effectively door-to-door, whereas Sunrun had historically relied upon digital lead generation, retail footprint, some of our channel partners. And so adding that sort of incremental route to market really expands our presence, where I think we can become, you know, the brand that's synonymous with residential solar and energy storage. There's a bunch of synergies to be found. In that we, you know, we see a lot of overlap in some of the back office operations and corporate overheads. And so, you know, meaningful financial value there that can be unlocked through the transaction as well. But it just sets us up to be, you know, the clear leader in an industry that has so much headroom left to grow.
And also another area that's expected to help the industry grow is the regulatory picture. That's what investors, I think, are focused on a lot also for 2021. So what are your thoughts on that? And how is that set to impact your business?
Yeah, you know, we've got a handful of things that I think are really compelling to lawmakers on both sides of the aisle. Some people are excited about what we're doing because of the, you know, decarbonization and environmental benefits. Some people are really excited about solar because it's been a phenomenal job creator over the last 10 to 15 years. You know, there's over 250,000 people that work in residential solar in the U.S. today. Has continued to be a great creator of good quality, high paying jobs. And so, you know, we see a lot of interest from both sides of the aisle. We applaud Congress. They extended the solar investment tax credit right at the tail end of December there. And so we're extended at the 26% level for two more years, which creates, you know, more opportunity for us to bring, you know, more value to consumers and to our business.
And looking ahead here, it looks like analysts are projecting a profitable year for Sunrun in 2021. And we talked about the acquisition a little earlier, but what else is enabling the company to continue to fuel its growth for the year ahead?
Yeah, one of the most exciting things about this business is just how early we are in it. And people forget that sometimes because residential solar has been around for a while. We've been on this journey for a while, and yet we're still at roughly 3% penetration in the US. If the industry were to grow at 15% every year for the next 10 years, we'd still only approach a 13% penetration of residential solar in the US. Consumers spend nearly $200 billion a year on residential electricity. Utilities spend over $100 billion more on capital expenditures every year. And so the opportunity for us to, you know, deploy to more homes is really untapped right now. And then for us to bring the assets we have, our solar and storage systems together to create networked virtual power plants to, you know, to bring more resiliency and reliability to the grid overall has been a really exciting area for us. So there's a lot of headroom left in this market. It's early days and we're on a long-term journey here.
Yeah, well, we'll have to leave it there. Thanks so much, Tom, for shedding light on all things Sunrun for us today. The solar industry has been very hot, and we're going to keep tabs on Sunrun.
Awesome. Thank you so much.
Hi there. Thanks so much for watching Investing Strategies on our YouTube channel. If you want more executive interviews and analysis of key trends to watch, make sure you hit the subscribe button so you can stay up to date.